What's up, guys? This is The Honest Outlaw here, and today we're going to be talking about the Mossberg Shockwave. I have had this particular firearm for quite a while, and I put quite a lot of rounds through it. Before we get into the review, I want to mention my patron supporters. Thank you guys very much. You guys keep the channel moving. I really appreciate all the support, and because of that, we do a monthly giveaway. I also want to mention ammo.com. They are supporting the channel as well. I leave a link in the description to their website for $20 off an order of $200 or more. Back to the Mossberg. So what is the Mossberg Shockwave? Well, it essentially is a 590 with a 14-inch barrel and a Raptor grip. Now, mine has gone through some transformations over the last year or so. At one point or another, I had a lot of accessories on it, and now you can see in front of the table, it's a little more slicked out than it was previously. And that's because I tried a few modifications that I actually didn't like. And I'm gonna probably just do a modification video right after this video, because I have had a few requests on it as well. But for now, I'll just give you the general gist of it. It's still got the same old Raptor grip. We're rocking the Mesa Tactical shot shell holder, Scalarworks. I always call it Scalarworks. People get mad at me. We have the Scalarworks mount with the Trigicon RMR Type 2, and I also have a GG&G, the triple G pick mount for a light. And I've actually used this particular platform to test a few lights that I actually forgot to review, like the TLR7 and the Surefire X300 Ultra 1000 lumen light. Both of those reviews should be coming down the pipe. Maybe when it gets a little bit warmer. Now that I've taken so long to do them, I might as well wait a little bit longer and do a super thorough review. But both of those lights were shot on this shotgun with zero problems. It is in 20 gauge. They do make this in 12 gauge, but I like the 20 gauge Shockwave because you do have to hold it kind of awkward to fire it, and the extra recoil of the 12 gauge would make that even more difficult. A lot of people discount the 20 gauge, and you shouldn't, because if you got hit by it, you'd notice. The ballistics on a 20 gauge are very impressive. Not quite as impressive as a 12, but still, compared to your average firearm caliber, very impressive. Because it has a 14 inch barrel, shorter than the legal length of 18 inches, if it had a stock, it would be classified as a shotgun. So these are produced as firearms. They were never shotguns, so you cannot take a shotgun and convert it to this. You can only take a receiver that was never a shotgun and can basically create a firearm with this particular Raptor grip. I think you can even have it with a pistol grip, but don't quote me on that. Anyway, Mossberg figured out this little loophole and has basically invented an entire new category of firearms, because not only is this out, Remington also has the TAC 14, I believe, and the new semi-automatic version of the Versamax, the TAC 13, is coming out here shortly as well. This was the original, and in my opinion, still one of the best. I really like Mossberg because Mossberg, unlike Remington, had a very quality name, made a very quality product for years, just like Remington did, except for Mossberg still does that today. Whereas the Freedom Group kind of ruined Remington and Remington's quality control. So you won't find too many products that I buy from them, at least with confidence. I might buy a few for review, but I would probably never buy a Remington product, at least a new one, for personal defense again, knowing that their failure rate is just so much higher than other companies, like Mossberg, for example. Now, this has a bead sight, a cylinder bore choke. It weighs about 4.9 pounds and has an overall length of 26 inches, about half the length of the standard 590 at around 41. And that's the real reason to buy this gun in the first place, is the length and the cool factor. It allows it to be more versatile, I guess, and a little more convenient to move and store and everything like that. Like if you needed something small to put under your car seat, or I don't know, reenact the Road Warrior, whatever you want to do with this gun, it has the cool factor and the mobility to do it, and it doesn't sacrifice a huge amount of shootability. You're definitely not going to be able to get the same times and same accuracy and overall performance that you would with a shotgun with a stock, but with enough training, I have found that this gun is more than capable. Now, a little more dive into why I chose the 20 gauge. First off, it has a lighter weight of overall package, about half a pound lighter than the 12 gauge. And as I said, it's easier to shoot for me, and especially easier to shoot for smaller frame shooters like my wife. My wife shot this gun several times and was capable with it, but it certainly wasn't her favorite.
Oh, got myself in the face.
Did you really? 20 gauge buckshot moves at about 1100 feet per second and produces roughly 1300 pounds of energy. That's only about 200 less than the 12 gauge, and that's about four rounds of 9mm at the same time. So the damage from this particular platform can be more than enough for anything that you would need, anywhere from people all the way up to a larger game. Now, what would you use this gun for? Well, I would use this for fun on the range, number one. The 20 gauge with its lower recoil than the 12, it's just a super fun platform to shoot. Even though it kind of stings a little bit more so than like a 5.56 would, or something with really low recoil like a 22, the bang you get out of this is a good time. And pumping the shotgun and just generally shooting it like you would from your old 80s action movies, it's a real old 80s action fantasy type of gun. Other than fun on the range, you could also use it for self-defense. You're not going to be carrying this around, but theoretically you could use it as a truck gun, and theoretically you could use it as a home defense gun. Now, a lot of tactical trainers out there are gonna hate me saying that. They're gonna say that this is dumb, you can't aim it, it's not as easy to use. Why not buy a shotgun? Why not buy a shotgun with a stock? And I partially agree with you. If you buy an 870 or a Mossberg 500 with a stock and an 18 inch barrel, you're gonna have a higher capacity, you're gonna have better hit probability because the stock's gonna be way easier to shoot. But if this was what you had and somebody broke in your house, they're not going to be happy about it. I mean, you can still be more than accurate with this up to 25 yards, and you're still shooting a 20 or 12 gauge round, depending on which particular caliber you go with, and you're still going to have five rounds of it. So five rounds of 20 gauge in a small enclosed area is more than proficient enough to deal with a home defense, home invasion scenario, in my personal opinion. Not only that, but a quick reload on the side. You could have nine rounds in the gun, pick it up, and go to work if you had to. And you're looking at it solely for home defense and from a practical mindset. The shotgun with the stock is going to be superior to this firearm without a stock. Out to 15 yards, it was easy for me to point shoot this shotgun, but I also have a little bit more experience and trigger time on guns in general, let alone shotguns I have a lot of experience with. So could you take this out of the box and shoot it effectively? Well, I can tell you my wife has very little experience with shotguns and firearms of this nature, and she didn't have too much of an issue at least getting the first shot on target. She had more of an issue of the battery of arms with the pump action in general, and that is something I don't like that people usually claim. They usually claim a pump action shotgun is the best gun for home defense for new shooters. Is it though? Because you have the complicated process of loading and unloading, the manual operation of the pump, the fact that you can short stroke the gun, more than average amount of recoil, all things to me negate that claim of being the best gun for newer shooters. Now, the ergonomics of this gun are pretty good for what it is. I was surprised at how well the bird's head grip worked, how comfortable it was in comparison to the vertical foregrip or the vertical pistol grip of a lot of the older shotguns that you see. I even had a Mossberg Maverick 88 about 10 years ago that had a pistol grip. It was a 12 gauge, and that thing was a bear to shoot. You know, we would shoot it one-handed and stuff because you do dumb stuff when you're young. But this gun, it makes it significantly more comfortable, and it's not near as hard on your wrist. Maybe the 20 gauge helps with that as well, but I've also seen plenty of videos of other expert instructors like Clint Smith from Thunder Ranch, for example, who also talk about how much more comfortable it is. I like the Mossberg Tang safety. I'm a huge fan of that. I think this is a big upgrade over the Remington. Now, there are some Remington fans out there who will say that this can inadvertently turn on and off depending on if you drop the gun or bump the gun or whatever. The ability to use this with both hands trumps all of that nonsense, in my personal opinion, and I think it's just the best possible spot for a shotgun safety. Going down the gun, you're going to find that the 14-inch length of the barrel makes the gun a lot more maneuverable, and it makes it more comfortable to carry around. If you're walking around all day and you have to carry a shotgun, a shorter barreled shotgun is just easier to manipulate. The downside of that is that you are going to have less capacity because the capacity of a shotgun directly relates to the barrel length. And the other ergonomic thing that you have to come into question is how you can shoot it effectively. Now, if you're not at least a fairly stout human being, I would not suggest you trying to use something like a red dot or something something like that to really get a good sighting system. Because if you were running a 12 gauge on this, let's say, and you were a 115 pound girl who'd never shot a gun before, and you fire one of these off looking down the sights, there's a fairly good chance this bird's head grip is going to knock out your two front teeth. So be careful with that, because the recoil of the gun, especially if you put it right up to your face, it does move it to the rear a little bit. Now, it's more than manageable, especially with a 20 gauge and especially with bird shot, which is what most people are going to be shooting. But if you're shooting a 3-inch buckshot load through a 12 gauge through this, put that in front of your face at your own discretion. And the other downside of that is, since you don't have a cheek weld, like I keep saying in this video, it certainly is going to be less accurate, and it's also going to be slower. That's one thing I didn't mention. If you're trying to get a super quick shot, the ability to just keep a stock in your shoulder and bring it up to your cheek weld real fast and fire the first shot, that's going to be a lot faster than picking this up and kind of searching for the dot or searching for the front sight, because you don't have a real good frame of reference without a stock. I'm still going to give this a 9 out of 10. And a lot of that is cool factor, a lot of that is innovation, and a lot of that is, well, just the Mossberg 500 590 platform to begin with. What they're really doing is they're taking one of the most standby and known and trusted shotguns in the world, and they're just putting a shorter grip on it. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Please help out your local homeless shelters, and remember to recycle. I'll check you later.
How about that? I like it. I don't mind it.
Really?
Yeah, I mean, it's got a little recoil, but it's easy to use, and it's not terrible.
Wow, okay. Because this has a 14-inch barrel, it is not allowed to have a stock, or it would be a short-barreled shotgun.